but I'm going to cover. My purpose is not to change your religion. My purpose is not to make you believe everything that I say. On the contrary, I'm the only one in the world that will tell you, listen to everyone, read everything, believe absolutely nobody, including me, including your mother, including your pastor, your preacher, your priest, your Uncle Bob, and anybody else that you can think of, unless you can prove it in your own research. And research doesn't mean getting a book off the library shelf and reading it and saying, well, he said it, so it must be true. Because I wrote a book, you see, and I'm telling you, don't believe me unless in your own research you can prove what it is that I'm telling you. Because this is the age of deception. And if you don't believe that, you might as well go home right now because you're in the wrong place. This is the age of deception. And everybody today is living in a fantasy world, and they're promoting agendas that they don't understand because somebody has told them that it's the right thing to do, and they generally believe it. Most people go to the church that they go to simply because their parents did, and for no other reason. Most people who are Democrats because their parents were. Are they Republicans because their parents were? If you ask them, what is a Republican, they couldn't tell you in 100 million years. They don't know. They vote that way because that's comfortable for them, because that's what they grew up with. Most of us do what we do because we grew up in it. So there is an awful lot about this environment around you shapes who and what you are. It's the truth. I had a woman at the post office where we live the other day say, I listen to your radio station every day. It's wonderful. But when Bill's show comes on, I turn it off because I don't want to be brainwashed. What is she admitting to? She's admitting that she's already been brainwashed because she is unwilling to listen to opposing viewpoints. That's the biggest number one sign of brainwashing that there is. It didn't matter that it was my show. It's any show. Any opposing viewpoint. Anything that opposes the status quo, if you won't listen to it, you're already brainwashed. You've closed your mind, and you are at the mercy of whatever manipulation they want to throw your way, because you've already determined that they're telling you the truth no matter what. You don't investigate. You have accepted blindly. That's the most dangerous thing that can happen to anyone. The moment that you say, this guy right here, I like him. I like what he says. He's right. I'm going to listen to him. And anybody that says anything different to him is wrong. You've just totally destroyed yourself. And I spend 99% of my time searching out the truth where none of you have ever looked. Some of you may have looked in some of the areas and some of the things that I've looked in, but I can guarantee you there's nobody in this room who has looked where I've looked as long as I have looked, as diligently as I have done it. Okay? What I'm going to try to do today is sort of give you some of what I've learned. And you can take it for whatever you think it's worth. I hope that you will take it out of here and use it to search for your own truth. Truth is not always cut and dried. It's not always black and white. You can't get into the concept that, hey, this is right and that is wrong and there is no in-between, because that's not true. There are all kinds of in-between all the time. And truth is elusive, folks. I have to tell you this. It's elusive at best, and it's hard to find. And the moment you think you know it all, you have lost yourself again. And I want you to understand this. If what I'm telling you up here is not true, it's not going to bother you. Okay. On my radio show, I use the term sheeple a lot. I can always tell when I hit the targets. Boy, I get the letters. How dare you call me a sheeple? That person wouldn't have wrote that letter if that person wasn't a sheeple. Because they would have known I wasn't talking about them, right? Only the person that the arrow hits gets angry. So the reason I'm telling you this, if you find what I'm talking about disturbing, I'm hitting you with some truth that is bothering you. That's really bothering you, and you need to look at it really closely, because it wouldn't be bothering you if it wasn't true. If it wasn't pinging on you personally with something that you know inside of you is not right, it's not going to upset you. And that's the truth. Everyone in this country knows that there is something wrong. They can feel it in their gut, but they can't put their finger on it. They can't identify it. They don't know what it is. They don't understand how a trusting people can be so easily subverted and manipulated. Our country is in the process of being destroyed. Not from a great enemy from without, not from the evil empire, not from Saddam Hussein. It's coming from within, folks, from within. We are being destroyed by our own apathy, the abdication of our power as a people. Remember, of, for, and by the people. You can't have of, for, and by the people if the people don't participate. It's impossible. Cannot be done. Wake up. Wake up. Wake up.
Talk about vice presidential possibilities.
You guys have got to try the cold chai.
This is William Bill Cooper. If you want the truth and are not afraid to hear it, Bill dedicated himself to it full time and died supporting the vision the Founding Fathers had left behind. Bill spent his entire life trying to wake up America by teaching us what we are not taught, exposing the lies that control us, and spreading the truth even as people began to grow more fearful of it, and it is our duty to carry on his legacy. Bill is remembered for his bravery, compassion, and care for the American people. He remains infamous for standing up and saying no when nobody else had the balls to do it. Bill predicted the events of September 11, 2001 on his radio show, The Hour of the Time, 3 months before the event took place. When the prediction came true, Bill was shot down and left for dead in the front lawn of his home by federal agents because he intended, as always, to expose the corruption that has taken America, more so than ever after the attack on the World Trade Centers. Today, his legacy is reignited, along with his message warning the public of where our futures are headed if we don't stand up for what this country is supposed to represent. Today, it seems a parasite has corrupted every facet of humanity, and dark times are indeed upon us. So if you are unfamiliar with Cooper's work, it is not too late to hear him, nor is it too late to be brave and take our country back.
It's unfortunate, but it's true. Our forefathers belonged to these secret societies. Now, some people have come to me and said, Bill, you claim the Constitution is so great, how can you do that and then say that our forefathers are members of the secret society that's trying to destroy this country and bring about the New World Order? They think there's a dichotomy there, and there's not. Because this was the grand experiment. It was also the antithesis to the monarchs, the kings and queens of Europe, whom they had sworn to topple from their thrones. How do you topple a king from the throne? You give the people, the subjects, a taste of freedom. You can go ahead and start, just walk around the camera if you will. All through history, let me give you a little background. All through history, man had claimed that he didn't need to be ruled by kings and queens, and that he wasn't property and he didn't want to be property. Because up until the time this country was founded, no people in this whole world had ever been free and had always been the property of the ruler. The king, the queen, the emperor, whatever they call themselves. Man was a property just like a cow was. What made somebody free, what made them capable of ruling, was genetics. Your line of genetic descent or ancestry determined whether you were going to be property or you were going to be a king. And nothing else determined that. Our forefathers, in their efforts to bring about their dream of a perfect world where they would not be oppressed by kings or queens, or by popes or religions, or by the mob. In their quest for that, they created this nation as the antithesis to the kings and queens and emperors and empresses of the old world. And they knew that they gave the common man a taste of freedom, that the kings and queens and emperors would topple off their thrones like dominoes in a row across the floor. And that's exactly what happened. Not long after this country was established, the French Revolution took place by the same groups. The same secret societies caused the French Revolution, caused the revolution in this country. All of our forefathers belonged to the Freemasons. They were all also Knights Templars. They were also members of the Illuminati. They were not bad men. The people who are bringing about the New World Order today do not believe themselves to be bad men. They believe it must be done in the best interest of mankind. And they believe that the end justifies the means, so that if they have to kill 2 billion people to realize the dream, there will finally be 1,000 years of peace. But their logic is convoluted, and they're tripping over their own philosophy in many places, as you will find out when you begin to seriously study this, if you do, and I hope that you do. They founded this country, and they gave us the most perfect document for ruling a country that has ever been written in the history of the world, the Constitution of the United States and the Bill of Rights. It did not give us freedoms. It restricted the government. It made us sovereign kings in our own right, and for the first time in the history of the world, made the government the chattel slave of the people. It reversed, turned the tables on everything that had gone before. They built into the Constitution and the Bill of Rights every tool that we would ever need to keep our freedom and stay free. They also built into the Constitution 2 things that would ensure our downfall should we prove unworthy of ruling ourselves. And it was the great experiment. Can man rule himself, or must he have a king? And those 2 things they built into the Constitution was the creation of a foreign country within this country called the federal government residing in the District of Columbia, Washington, D.C. I'm tired of life.
From where I stand today, it is true. The human condition has been corrupted, and a parasite has infiltrated our realm and our consciousness. Disguised as leaders we vote for, the idols we worship, the false concepts we believe in. It's not just America. Mankind is at the brink, and the truth has been weaponized, meaning it's more painful than ever to face. As Bill Cooper said himself, and I quote, "Learn what the truth really is. Get away from the fantasy you've been living. Educate other people, those around you, your family. Once that begins to happen, the truth spreads." End quote.
This is the age of deception. This is the age of deception. This is an age of deception that no human has ever experienced in the history of this world.